Hello, everyone. Thanks for joining us here on Horizon. I'm Rob McClendon. Well, since 1950, the number of people employed in agriculture has plummeted in industrial nations around the world. But the declining number of farmers does not imply a decline in the importance of the farming sector. The world, well, it still has to eat. So smaller number of farmers means larger farms and a turn towards mechanization and the inevitable disconnect between those who grow our food and the rest of us that eat it. That's why Oklahoma has been in the forefront of developing Ag in the Classroom curriculum, an effort to teach our youngest generation the role agriculture plays in our lives. The lessons are varied and very hands-on. And each year, both students and teachers are honored for their work during Ag Day at the state capitol. And we were there to recognize this year's Ag in the Classroom Teacher of the Year, Debra Deskin.
No bees, no honey,
no work.
Ag in the Classroom is a way of helping students understand where their food, their clothes, and their shelter come from. So it's teaching agricultural literacy, and it's connecting it with the standards that teachers are already teaching in their classroom. So they can make connections to their math, their science, their social studies, language arts. They could tie it into physical education or art education.
Raise your hand. How could cherries be brought someplace by birds? How could they all of a sudden start growing somewhere and birds be related?
It's so important. Ag in the Classroom has made it so much fun. It's one of those things I enjoy coming into class and knowing I'm going to get to do some activities with that. If I could tie ag into every lesson I do, then I'm going to be happy with it.
We would have 2 mouths in 1 year. Mark Twain.
So we talked about the history, how the cherry got here. We talked about, okay, how it really got here by birds. So you throw your science in that as well. We did graphing for our math. Second grade, that is one of our standards, is graphing. So they did a bar graph with it. Talking about George Washington, tying that into President's Day, the old story about cutting down the cherry tree, when they talked about, okay, that really didn't happen. It was just to encourage being honest. So you can actually have some character education with it as well.
She's make sure that her students here in Edmond understand about agriculture, even though they're not living on the farm.
It's kind of a sad thing that they don't understand maybe where, you know, milk or even just the ice cream comes from. And you say, okay, where would you get ice cream from? They're going to say the store or Brahm, especially for here in Oklahoma. But before that, where does it come from?
Good.
And it's colored by a student right here at Orvis Riser Elementary. Jada Hutchinson, come on down.
We don't just have a student winner, we have a teacher winner.
Guess what? Ms. Deskin is the state Ag in the Classroom teacher.
What makes Ms. Deskin so successful is her excitement and her enthusiasm. It's contagious. She is genuinely excited to teach the students. You can tell her class loves her. She takes that enthusiasm into the classroom. She expands on their regular learning experiences so that they love coming to school, they love learning. And then she takes that enthusiasm to other teachers. So when she presents at our state Ag in the Classroom conferences, her excitement and enthusiasm is broadcast into everyone that comes in contact with her. And then the message of agriculture spreads throughout the state. So we're so excited that she is going to be representing us for the next year as our state Ag in the Classroom Teacher of the Year. And we're excited that she'll be joining us this summer on our road trips and being able to share more knowledge with more teachers.
Don't be part of the problem.
Be part of the solution.